There's one ingredient that is common to almost every drink that gets passed over the bar and usually makes up about a quarter of it, and yet often gets overlooked, and that is ice. Ice and cocktails go hand in hand, and it's believed to be one of the main reasons that cocktail culture took off so much in the States. If you look at the original definition of the cocktail in 1806, it only mentions water, because ice just didn't exist on a commercial level. But around the same time, at the beginning of the 1800s, a man named Frederick Tudor started harvesting ice from glaciers in huge blocks, and it was actually delivered around the country by horse and carriage. And this is where we start to see the rise of ostentatiously cold drinks like juleps and cobblers. In fact, during the gold rush in Australia, ice was imported all the way from Canada just so that people could show how wealthy they were by how frosty their sherry cobbler was. By the mid-1800s, the first ice machine was invented, and we have never looked back to room temperature drinks since. So, the big question. Are bartenders trying to rip you off by putting lots of ice in your drink? The short answer is absolutely not. The simplified long answer is that ice keeps ice cold and keeps cold liquid cold, so the more of it there is, the colder and less diluted your drink will be. Asking for less ice just means that you will get more mixer in your glass and the whole thing will end up a watery mess much faster. It has absolutely zero effect, I repeat, zero effect on how much booze is in there. This is also why drinks which have been pre-diluted, i.e. cocktails which have been stirred or shaken already, should be served on the biggest block of ice you can get your hands on, as you just want the drink to remain cold and not dilute much more. Which takes us on to shaking and stirring. Both chill and dilute the cocktail, but shaking does it faster and changes the texture at the same time. Hence why booze-forward cocktails such as old fashions and martinis should be stirred, and fresh and spritzy cocktails such as daiquiris and margaritas should be shaken, and hard. Either way, the same goes as for mixed drinks. The more ice, the better, so cram as much in your shaker or mixing glass as physically possible. As an industry, we are in a glorious second ice age. Bartenders really care about the ice going into your drinks. You might have seen or used the beautiful big clear blocks of ice. They usually come from specialised equipment which freezes massive blocks of ice from one end to the other, meaning that all of the impurities get forced out of the block rather than getting trapped in the middle and going cloudy. A good way to achieve this on a budget is to fill a drinks cooler with water and freeze it with the top off, as it will freeze from the opened end first and so leave you with the cloudy part at the bottom, which you can just chop off with a bread knife. This is obviously not feasible for everyone, it's kind of more of a bar situation. So the best way around that is to boil the water before you freeze it so that it's as pure as possible before it's frozen. And as a fun fact, hot water actually freezes quicker than cold water anyway. To be perfectly honest though, unless the water where you live is particularly unpalatable or you're freezing your ice in a freezer which is also host to particularly strong smelling foods, I wouldn't stress too much about it in a home bar situation. Just invest in some 1-inch ice molds for shaking and stirring, and big blocks or balls for serving, and freeze way more than you think that you're gonna need. And if in a pinch you can only get your hands on some party ice, don't stress about it, just take that into consideration and stir or shake for a little bit less time. So, basically, size really does matter. For those of you that want to have a little bit of a geek out, I've got some links to some more scientific explanations below, but hopefully you'll all give this humble ingredient the respect that it deserves from here on out. So now you know, and keep watching to see how to chill the perfect margarita.